is green, it's green, oh, oh. The land is green, it's green, can't you see? The harvest is ready, 'cause the Lord of the harvest told me so. It's green for me.
That is down needs fear no fall. He that is low no pride. He that is humble ever shall have God to be his guide. I am content with what I have, little be it or much, for God's contentment shall I crave, for thou savest such. With that little poem of mine, I say welcome to my Nigerian dream, where we dream small and the dream turns out to be something spectacular, something huge. My name is Anire Benitia. It's such a joy to be with you again on my Nigerian dream. My Nigerian dream is a place where possibility is born, is a place where hope begins to rise. It's a place where you are told that you are not useless. You are not a complete write-off. It can become so only if you say so. My Nigerian dream is about fighting for what you believe in. My Nigerian dream is about believing in your God-given talent. You and God, believing that you can succeed no matter the odds. That is what this program is about. This program was built, it was born for someone like you. Someone who believes that is a total write-off. Someone waiting for a godfather. Someone who believes an uncle will make all his answers, all his dreams come true. Mm-mm. When you watch this program, you come in contact with men and women who have succeeded or are still in the process of pursuing success. But once upon a time, the story wasn't like that. It was bleak, it was useless. But today, you and I will sit back and watch as they tell their stories, because indeed the story has changed. Today, they are celebrated. These are the men you call stars today. These are the men you desire to be like. But once upon a time, people, it wasn't that way. This man begged. They stayed in people's houses. They were squatters. Sometimes they didn't even have food to eat. On this program, you'll get to hear the stars that you so much desire to be like tell you that once upon a time stayed in a shop. You're going to hear stories that will humble you on this program. That is why I want you to stick with me, because when we return, definitely, the story will begin.
I can't see all the harvest is ready, 'cause he told me so. It's green and it's all mine.
Welcome back. Yes, I'm still here. I'm not going anywhere, because I know definitely that I have your attention. Nigerian Dream is about stories, people. We tell good stories. Well, stories that was once upon a time not that good. Just like the one you're going on right now, you're going through some messy period in your life and you're like, oh, there's no hope. You're about to throw in the towel. You're about to do something nasty. This program is for you. This program is built to inspire, to set off that fire inside of you, to make you know that you can make it. Even in Nigeria, the Americans have their dream. We all know the American dream. One day you're a bartender, the next minute you're making top charts all over the world and you're celebrated. It's happening right here in your own country. And that is the story we want to tell on this program. My Nigerian Dream is a story of hope. Believe me, And you can only find out if you stay with me on this beat. The guest that we have today on this program is going to shock you when you hear his story. Is your typical Ajebota. Is the guy every girl wants to go out with. Believe me, is one of the guys around where a pregnant woman will say, come and touch me so my baby will look like you. He's celebrated now, but once upon a time, it wasn't so. Stay with me as you find out the guest that we have on our program today. When he came back from the States, he said he squatted. Himself and his brother, they were squatters for 8 months in one of the most popular musicians' houses that we have in Nigeria. I'm not going to let the cat out of the bag. Stay with me, people, because you get to find out that your story is nothing compared to the story you're going to hear right here. Despite the fact that their parents had money, they still had to survive like men, and today the story's changed. Well, I'm not going to talk too much. Just sit back as we go to the first segment in our program, which is Notable Quotes. Yes, you already know what it is. Stay with me, people. When we come back, my Nigerian dream will continue. I'm beginning to warm up, right? This is the moment where the fire begins to get kindled, you know? I'm an Nigerian dream. The momentum just gathers and gathers and gathers. And now we're going right on to the next segment, which is the great speech segment. Like I tell you every time we come, you know, on this program, the great speech segment is to inspire you, is to lighten that fire inside of you, is to raise your spirit, to make you know that nothing is impossible unless you say so. Stay with me.
The inches we need are everywhere around us.
Hell yeah.
They're in every break of the game, every minute, every second. On this team, we fight for that inch. On this team, we tear ourselves and everyone else around us to pieces for that inch. We claw with our fingernails for that inch. Because we know when we add up all those inches, that's gonna make the fucking difference between winning and losing. Between living and dying. I'll tell you this, in any fight, it's the guy who's willing to die who's gonna win that itch. And I know if I'm gonna have any life anymore, it's because I'm still willing to fight and die for that itch. Because that's what living is. The 6 inches in front of your face. Now I can't make you do it. Now I can't do it for you.
This kid's gonna be the best kid in the world. This kid's gonna be somebody better than anybody ever knew. And you grew up good and wonderful. It was great just watching. Every day was like a privilege. Then the time come for you to be your own man and take on the world, and you did. But somewhere along the line, you changed. You stopped being you. You let people stick a finger in your face and tell you you're no good. And when things got hard, you started looking for something to blame. Like a big shadow. Let me tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you want to be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.
And they will know what we can do.
I'm gonna show you how great I am.
Welcome back. Welcome back. Welcome back. Did you hear all that motivational speech? Did you get to read all those inspirational quotes? It's important for you. It's all about building up the momentum as we get into the interview proper. And today we're going right onto the interview segment. I told you earlier on that we have a guest, your typical butter, your typical Fanta, your typical fine boy, no pimples, looking all suave, looking all sweet, you know? You see him on the screen and you wish to be like him. Boy, when you hear the stories, the things he had to go through for him to become the success that he is now, I'm sure you would just pull off that part of his life and just stick with the success part. Yes, we were looking for a soft landing. Stay with me, people, as I bring you our guest on my Nigerian Dream today, telling us a seemingly grass to grace story. It wasn't easy. Listen and be inspired. Be read. Watch.
I can see all the harvest is ready, cause he told me so. It's green and it's all mine.
What up, my people? This is your boy, Be Red. HK Music in the building. My name is Bayo Adeleke. I'm on a site currently signed to HK Music. When I'm ready Decca, Atlanta, Georgia. We were friends with the Moet Records crew when they were still together. It was consisted of the band, Don Jazzy, Dr. Sid, Wanda Co, everybody, you understand. So I remember when they used to come to America, we used to pick them up from the airport and everything. We used to see the way they used to live their life and everything. And up back then, we were still upcoming artists, like trying to make it in the industry, you understand. So we always told them, the band, them, like, oh, my boss, want to come back and blow, help us. They said, bro, trust me, just you have to, for you to blow, you have to come back to Nigeria and hustle. So 2 years went by. I remember when I used to have to wake up at like 6 o'clock in the morning. I used to cook at my brother's school called Georgia Perimeter College. I used to go there by 6 a.m. and finish by 5 p.m. every day. It's only my mom that believed me. Because they were saying, there's too many artists out there, you can't just be big like that. So, for all of you watching out there, I know there's somebody out there like, is thinking like, oh my God, this is the last stage of my life. I don't have money, I don't have this. See, bro, can I be honest with you, it was a point in time that before I got my job in America, me and my brother Shinambo were living with one guy named Jamok, a Jamaican guy. We didn't pay no rent, we lived there for free. We had no money. Despite the fact that my dad has money and David's father has money, he didn't help us. As a man, you have to help yourself, you understand? So basically, it got to a point that the couches, this is before God and man, the couches, we had to lift the couches under. You know, sometimes you have money in your pocket, it can come out. We had to look under the couch and see if we can get money to go and find food. This is true talk, you understand? And at that particular time in America, I was like, God, my family is rich, but why am I here? You understand? I'm supposed to be doing something in my life. I got to a point, I wanted to cry. I was crying every day, like, God, please help us. And you can't help me. God can't help you unless you help yourself. That's what people don't understand, you understand? So I'm sure there's somebody out there that's like, oh my God, I feel like dying. I don't have money. I don't have a house to stay. You have a house to stay. You just don't want to go and find it, you understand? So just have that drive. So anybody out there that is struggling to get to the top, trust me, even if it takes 10 years, keep on going. One day finally you get there, you understand? Maybe today we don't get your money. No, you don't get your money. Now every day in case you don't know. And if you give them chance, they gon' misbehave. I never back down all the way. So come around now, let's celebrate. Now they head to now, no more jewel. If I, B-Red from HKM Music, can come from America just to come to Nigeria, have no house. Okay, obviously my dad in the house, but I'm a grown man, like, you expect to go live in my dad's house. So me coming from America and everything like that, with no home, no job in Nigeria, just me, my cousin Davido and Shinrambo, believing that there's a God out there, and when we come here, we'll hustle and make it, you understand? If I can make it, B-Red, you can make it, because I have two hands and I have two legs. It's about getting off your bum and going to help yourself. If you want to be an artist, believe in yourself, get up, move around and make it. If you want to be an actress or actor, a businessman, work in oil and gas, you're not going to make it if you're just sitting at home praying to God. God said pray to him, but in the meantime you're praying to him, help yourself and you help him. So if I can make it, you can make it even more. Understand? I'm okay, so won't let me rest. Everywhere we go, we VIP. Now everybody want to be like me. See them, they paparazzi me. No, but today we don't let your money. Now every day in case you don't know. This is my Nigerian dream. I keep on watching this with your homegirl Anere. You understand? This is B-Red. Come from the HKN stable. Everybody wanna know B-Red, yo. Won't come to jail, B-Red, yo. Cause they see me for TV, yo. Homo gays won't let me rest, yo. Everywhere we go, VIP. Ladies and gentlemen, stay locked down. Keep on supporting your boy, B-Red. One thing, don't forget, keep the peace. One love. And if you give them chance, they gon' misbehave. I never back down all the way. So come around now, let's celebrate. Now they heads now, one more jewel. All on me, what do you know? Now I'm here now, I never fall. See where the money goes. End up in the rush. No stress, we're on top. Baby girl, we're on top. Yeah. You watch me, little mama. I love. You watch me, little mama. I love. You watch me, watch
What more can I tell you? You already heard all the story. I don't need to add anything. I don't need to edit anything. You already heard. He had to work to become who he is today. Despite the fact that his parents had money, despite the fact that he was related to Davido, they didn't dwell on their parents' wealth. They became men and they went, went all the way out to assert themselves. They went out to fight for success. You too can fight for success. You too can become anything you desire to be. All you need to do is rise up, is to stand up like a man, is to pursue your dream, pursue your desires. Don't stop until success blinks at your face. This is why we say goodbye today. But remember, same time, next week is another time on my Nigerian dream. Believe me, if these people can make it, you too can. Bye.
The land is green, it's green, oh, oh. The land is green, it's green, can't you see? The harvest is ready, 'cause the Lord of the harvest told me so. It's green.